tampons in Ireland are taxed as a luxury item.
I got an urge to do a birth chart reading.
Brands that actually stand for something.
I just feel so flat today.
Here's to not shutting up ever anytime soon.
Good vibes, yeah, we bought them.
Good morning. Happy Monday. Do you know what? I'm lying to you, lads. It's no more morning now. It is literally 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock on a Monday, and I'm here saying good morning. So I'm just gonna start this vlog off by referencing last week's Sunday post, because last Sunday I made the decision to not post a Sunday vlog because I thought it was, to be honest, number one, I wasn't in the headspace to edit a Sunday vlog, and number two, I didn't want to post one. Like, I felt I was very insensitive by posting it. So that's why I posted the video that I did talking to you about white privilege and racism and what you can do, you know, resources, like there's all links in the video and everything. And I didn't do that video for views. I did that video because I wanted to talk to you as if you were my friends, kind of thing. So I hope you can respect my decision for doing that, to be honest. And like, this isn't a me problem, like I'm not trying to make this about me, but I've been so torn ever since I posted the video. I was like, was it the right thing to do? Was it the wrong thing to do? I was like, I don't want anyone to take me up wrong. I've watched it myself countless times. I toyed with the idea of taking it down. I was like, oh God. But then I was like, you know what? I said what I feel I should have said to anyone who was white who was watching it. Like, if I had a conversation with you as a white person to another white person, that's exactly the same thing I would have said. And yeah, I just don't want to be silent. I'm not the type of gal to brush issues under the carpet and not discuss them and not discuss anything. Yeah, it's 4 o'clock on Monday. I went to Kate's house yesterday. We had like a garden party. I was drinking. I don't feel hungover, but I don't feel great overall. I don't want to mask it on camera and be like, hey guys, I'm having a great day, because I'm not. Like, I'm really not. I was watching Erica Cody. She's an Irish artist, musician. I was watching her story because she's at the protests in Dublin at the moment. So I was watching that because she went live on her Instagram. So I was watching that. Insane, the turnout at the protests in Dublin for obviously George Floyd, but it's bigger than that. Like, it's for the whole Black Lives Matter movement. So I was watching that. I haven't worked out or anything today. I don't feel like it. It's the most stunning day outside. I should go for a walk. I should do something. I just feel so flat today. This week I really want to raise my vibration because I feel like I've been very flat the last few days, and like, I feel like you can empathize with what's going on in the world and be proactive and do all those things, and you can still have a high vibration and try to keep your mood and your mind very positive, which is what I'm struggling with at the moment, especially today. I don't know what you want me to say. I don't know what I want me to say. I don't know where this came from, but I got an urge to do a birth chart reading. I don't know, I just, the last few days and the last week, I felt very disconnected energetically and spiritually. And I was like, you know what? I've been eyeing up this gal on Instagram who does birth, like live birth chart readings on Zoom. And I just went onto her Instagram and clicked the link in her bio and booked one for 5:30. It's 4:30 now. So yeah, I'm gonna be doing that. I actually can't believe I just did this. I booked it with Dana. She's an astrologist on Instagram, and the recommendation came from Tara Mears. I think Tara Mears did her course. She does courses, like astrology courses. And I went onto her Instagram and I booked in with her. So I'm doing that at 5:30. So I will let you know how that goes. I'm very intrigued. because I know my birth chart, but I kind of just want to be explained it more. I just got shivers in my spine. I feel like that's a good thing, because I was like, before I booked out, I asked the universe, I was like, if I shouldn't be doing this, give me a sign. And I didn't get any sign, and now I have shivers and I'm very excited. So I'll let you know how that goes. I'm actually shook. I am so obviously I just finished my Zoom reading with Dana, and like, I don't know what pulled me to do that today, but I am so happy I did, because I don't know, for the past like week or even few weeks, I've been feeling this energy of like almost like self-doubt or like questioning, being like, what am I doing? Like, am I doing the right thing? Am I supposed to be doing what I'm doing now? Am I supposed to be doing something different? Like, I just had like a strong energy in my life, or not my life, but like my mind. The second I started on that Zoom call, it was like an hour and 45 minutes long. I'll link her Instagram down below if any of you want to check her out, if any of you would like to get a birth chart reading. Now, it isn't cheap, but it's, I wouldn't say it's expensive either. Like, it was definitely very worth it to me, and it was just the most spiritually like affirming thing I've ever done. Like, it basically affirmed everything I would kind of think, or I would think in my head. Do you know the way sometimes you think those things in your head and you're like, am I being crazy? Or like, when you are kind of pulled to something. So she basically, anyway, said that like the way my birth chart is set up is like, I am meant to be someone like a YouTuber. Like, I'm meant to be someone who has like this ability to make people feel welcome and make people feel inspired and make people feel like this positive energy that I do have and that I do possess. That's, it was just the most amazing thing ever. Like, 10 out of 10 out of 10 out of 10 recommend. I feel a million, like a zillion times better. So she basically sent me a key to like all my houses and everything like that, and she's sending me like the whole reading, and so yeah, it was absolutely amazing. Like, it was, I'm just in awe. I am wowed. I am in shock. I am also staring. Oh my god, but I feel just like, yes, like, oh my god, oh my god. Hello everyone, happy Tuesday. It is Tuesday again, not morning at all, 20 past 2. I woke up, so basically, remember how I was saying I did the birth chart reading yesterday? I think getting a birth chart reading is, I don't know why I waited 26 years. Like, oh my god, I connected with it so much. And she said like as well that because of my chart and like my placements and stuff, that she was like, you're quite an intuitive person. Like, you have like a massive spirituality about you. And she said that like, I have very high energy. So like, she was like, if you feel like you've manifested things before, she was like, it's probably because you have. And she was saying about like my positive energy and stuff, and like that I need to use that and be a voice for that. So here's to not shutting up ever anytime soon. Here's to that. On a more serious note, today is Blackout Tuesday. Now, obviously it's Sunday now, so I don't know. I know that I'm going to be silent more or less on my Instagram about things that aren't echoing the movement of anti-racism and what is going on, because I just think it is tone deaf of me to do anything other than that. And I've been vocal before about the fact I know I'm white, like that I am privileged because I'm white. I've been vocal before about this. Like, I have shared things on my story before, I have like spoke about it before, I have, like, I'm not saying I'm a great person, that I'm better than anyone who hasn't, but this isn't new in my mind, this whole anti-racism movement. And I know for a lot of you, it is more new in your mind because maybe this has drawn way more attention to it than you were ever forced to think about. And that is a version of white privilege. But just know that because you're forced to think about it now, and because it's all over social media, that if you educate yourself now, and if you, you know, have that thing inside you that, oh, like, I should know more about this, I can't believe I didn't know more about this, that's a good thing. So if you've seen that and just kind of been like, oh yeah, it's fine, it doesn't really affect me, whatever, then that's what kind of is worrying, you know? So I've just been posting a lot of resources to my story. Like, in Ireland, there's this thing called direct provision, which I informed myself more on last night, and that is horrible. Direct provision is basically what Ireland's structure is in place at the moment for its asylum seekers. So at the moment, any asylum seekers that come to Ireland are basically treated horrendously, and that is all due to direct provision, and obviously the current government allows it. So I have a link in my bio, I'll put it in the description as well, to, it's a petition, it only has like 4,000 signatures.
Okay, so as of right now, the petition actually has 38,100 signatures. So if you haven't signed it already, the link is in the bio. Also, don't know what's up with this quality. Like, this is a new 2019 MacBook Pro, and it looks like I'm filming in 2002. So Apple, honey, get it together.
Which some of you would be like, oh, that's a lot, but like, it needs more, basically. Oh, it's over, oh my God. Last night it had 4,200 and now it has 6,823. So that's good. They're like positive changes. So I have the link to that in my bio. I'll put it in the description. I've been informing myself of that. And if you want to watch someone online who's kind of gonna just not get into politics and not get into sensitive things, like, you're subscribed to the wrong gal. You were subscribed to the wrong gal, sweetie. Also, actually, I might as well inform you now, seeing as it is the 2nd of June. Where did the first go? Dunno. But for the entire month of June, any money that any of my YouTube paycheck for June is going to be donated. I'm gonna split it into a few different charities that I think are worthwhile donating to at the moment. So they will be all in relation to helping the Black Lives Matter movement and helping the problem of direct provision and racism and everything like that. And obviously, as the month develops, you know, it will become more apparent to me what I am donating to. Honestly, I will be sharing where the money is going to. I'm not lying to you, I'm not saying it to earn more money, because I know some people are probably like, oh yeah, she is. But yeah, so that is what I have decided to do for the month of June. So I still will be posting 3 videos a week. It's very important to be vocal on what's going on, but also I'm not going to be blind to the fact that people are still going to be watching content online. So at least if people are watching my content, the money that is generated from that can go somewhere good, and I can still, you know. Does that make sense? Hello, all you beautiful, beautiful people. Good evening, good night even. It's actually literally like Wednesday's gone. It's Wednesday night. I didn't vlog today just because, sorry, look at the curl. Ringlet. I had ringlets when I was younger in my hair, and then I damaged the shite out of it with heat and colour and bleach. So we're working on getting my hair healthy again. Also, I have my period, so that's fun. We love that for me. It's actually fine though. If any of you watch the vlogs, you will have known last month, I don't know what happened, but my insides were torturing me. But this month, the cramps are there, but I think compared to last month, like, anything will be fine. Good morning. Woo! Hello, hello, happy Thursday. Lads, look at the weather I woke up to. It's actually made me kind of happy. It's a rainy, cold, dull day. I'm not mad about it. To be honest, my bedroom is on the third floor, so my room has been like a sauna for the past week. Because obviously I live in Ireland and like there's no air con or anything, so my room has been like a sauna. And I love, if you know one thing about me, you should know that I love like fresh air. Like I love opening the windows and fresh air and airing out the room. I don't know, it's just been a thing I always love. So yeah, I'm gonna get up now, have my morning monster, you know the vibe, and I'm gonna work out. Hello, hi. Good morning. Happy Friday. I don't want to be too loud now because it's my brother's birthday today. So it's Ben's birthday. He's 19. We love a Gemini. A birthday. Oh my God, that's so weird. So my birthday was on a full moon and his birthday is on a full moon. Except he does, like, if I told him that, he'd literally tell me where to go, so. But his birthday is on the Sagittarius full moon. That's, like, a big deal. Because it's all about, like, change and stuff. Anyway, enough about me and the moon. But it's his birthday, right? So I'm going to town now, because he's still asleep. He won't be up for a while. And I'm getting, like, balloon, because yesterday was really rainy, so I couldn't walk to town. Sorry. But I'm getting like balloons and like a few of his favourite things. And so me and my brother, me and Jack, Jack is my other brother, he's in Australia, meeting the fam, you know. But we got him AirPods for his birthday. Now he has wanted AirPods for the longest and Jack was the one who suggested it, and I was like, oh yeah, do you think he'll like them, like, or whatever, and he's like, oh yeah, so we got him the AirPods anyway, and they're up in my room, and he was saying during the week, I heard him and mom, like, kind of having an argument, and basically, his mom was like, what do you want for your birthday, and he was like, all I want is AirPods, like, and I was like, I'm not buying you, because mom knew, see, we had them, so mom was like, I'm not getting you them, like, they're so expensive, like, you're not, like, you know, they're only headphones, like, I'd rather get you something nice or something you'd get use out of or whatever. So, he said to me, it's not like I expect them, but, like, because he was like, if she's going to spend that money on me anyway, I'd rather her get me AirPods. And I was like, Ben, I don't know. I was like, do you really want AirPods? Do you know the way, then you're throwing someone off the scent. So, anyway. Got him the AirPods, so I'm gonna go to town now and just get him like, Joe, a few other bits, like his favorite chocolate or something. And sorry, I'm just looking at my skin in the viewfinder. She's going off this morning, ladies and gentlemen. But yeah, so I'm gonna do that now, and then I want to put the AirPods in something so that like he won't get it. But I need to be smart. Like, I wanted to put them in, like, a shoebox. But I'm like, no, I don't want it. Because he loves shoes. So I was like, no, I don't want to get him excited about shoes. In case. So I might put it in, like, a chocolate box. I remember before, with my ex, I got him. He was obsessed with this computer game, Football Manager. And I got him the Football Manager. And I put it into, like, as if he didn't know, like... Like, he knew by the wrapping anyway, but I put it into, like, this random DVD case. And I was like, oh, I thought we could, like, watch the DVD. And he just looked at me. He's like, do you think I'm thick? And I opened it, and the Football Manager thing was inside. Because I'm just full of surprises. But, yeah, I'm going to go to town now, and I'll see you later. As I'm actually in Egypt, so I'm home from town. I'm so warm. But I got... I'm such an idiot. So I got a birthday cake in Super Value and I put it in the bag, not thinking. It's like buttercream sponge, but it says happy birthday on it. But I'm pretty sure now it just says happy birth because the D, I think happy is still intact, but it just says happy birth. but I'm sure I can fix it. It looks worse because the plastic's over it, but I'm just gonna leave that there. And I'll show you what else I got for Ben. So it's his birthday. So I just got this Marvel bag to put everything into. I don't even know, does he like Marvel really? But that's just his birthday bag. Lads, you've no idea, like, I'm obsessed with birthdays. So he loves Reese's Pieces, so I got him them. I got him Dairy Milk Oreo, because I feel like you can't go wrong with that. He loves Lindt, so I got him a bar of Lindt. Chili Doritos, and then this is a John Doe's donut, a Kinder Bueno one. So I think I'm gonna put a candle in that so he can blow it out, because realistically, because of coronavirus, you're not supposed to blow out your candles on your birthday cake, which makes sense. And to be honest, I always found it kind of disgusting that people were like spitting on the cake, but at least the whole world has realized that now. And then I got a happy birthday banner. There's two of them in here. Wrapping paper, confetti balloons that I had on my birthday, just because I think they're fun. And then this is just like random stuff. Mom wanted scones and fresh sausage rolls, and then just a few other bits. Got some tampons. Period's nearly gone though, so I only got a small box. Also, sorry now, look at this box of tampons, yeah? Did you know? Because I only found this out last week, and if you live in Ireland, this will be very relevant to you, and I'm sure it's probably similar in other parts of the world, but tampons in Ireland are taxed as a luxury item. But wait for it, men's razors, essential, is taxed as an essential item. So I'd say the tax on an essential item might be like, I don't know, 5 or 10%, I'm not sure. But then the tax as a luxury might be like 30 or like, so tampons are taxed as luxury items, but men's razors, necessity. Women's razors though are luxury. How does that make sense? Sorry, like, it's actually man's world. It's a white, straight man's world. Like, it really is. It is a white, straight man's world. Luxury item. Anyway, so I didn't want to buy a big box of tampons because, you know, I was like, I only need a small box and they're 150, bargain. But yeah, also I would love to try a menstrual cup. Has anyone ever tried one? Comment down below if you have. Also, I got something very exciting. Well, I think it's exciting. Let's sit down while I chat. So as you all know, I religiously take hair supplements. I've been taking them for years, kind of on and off. And to be honest, I think they make the quality of my hair, my skin, my nails better. And also, like, my hair has been through it. Like, it has been any color you think of, my hair has been that color. Like, purple, blue, black, like a reddish color, like a purpley color, pink, bleach blonde, ombre, like light brown, dark brown, light blonde, kind of sandy blonde, pink, like most of the colors that your hair can be. So obviously, like, I like to keep my hair very thick. The ends are kind of, see the way the ends are like this reddy color now? That's because my hair needs a trim, number one, and number two, all this hair at the bottom of my head was bleach blonde. So what I did is I dyed it black to, you know, cover it, but I only use semi-permanent dye in the hairdressers, obviously. So the ends are kind of getting that reddish color now because obviously there's blonde underneath. But anyway, I'm rambling. But I take hair supplements, so Hair Burst. You've probably seen me show them or talk about them before. And then Miss Kiki Nugent, Miss Kiki Fit, I'd love how I call her Kiki Fit, like, she's my one-to-one personal trainer at the moment, but I always see her mentioning that she takes biotin for her hair. And I know what biotin is, like, I know it's the main ingredient, say, in my hair supplements that would make your hair grow, along with like collagen. And like, Hair Burst supplements do have a lot of really good ingredients. I'll put them on the screen here. You can pause the video and read. So it does have a lot, but I was intrigued to know how much biotin is in them. So I take like the recommended daily amount, and in the recommended daily amount, there is 250 milligrams of biotin. Now, I found these in Holland & Barrett
and their biotin, and there's 300 mg in one tablet. And it says you can take 1 to 4 a day. So that would be like 1,200 mg that you can take compared to my tablets that have 250 mg. So I'm gonna keep taking my hair bursts just cause I have them. I always buy them on offer, buy one, get one for 1 cent. So it's only 15 euro for 30 days. This was 10 euro and there's 100 tablets. So if you took 3 a day, that would last you kind of a month as well. But you'd be getting 3 times the amount of biotin, really 4 times. So I'm gonna introduce this in and see, does my hair shoot down to my arse or what's the crack? But yeah, I'll keep you updated on that I need to blow up balloons, my camera battery's flashing. So I'll talk to you later.
This is what I've got here, which is kinda cute. I'm the birthday queen. I'm vlogging on my phone now. And then I have everything set up here. So I got him a donut with candles so he can blow it out on, because obviously birthday cake he can't. And then sausage rolls, a scone, Doritos, a curd, and then I wrap the AirPods in like a big box to throw them off the scent. And then I put more bunting up there and I put more up there. So it's all very exciting. I called him down now, so any minute now.
Happy birthday, dear Benjamin.
He's only 19.
Do you know what? With great news.
Ben Jemima.
From Monday, you can go anywhere.
Sorry, you don't go to camp, or what's the story?
Ben Jemima.
You don't go to camp?
Yeah.
What? What do you mean you don't think so? You're not going anywhere in the... You're not going anywhere in the country, like.
Ben.
Nice one.
Go for the present first, go on.
You're not putting that anywhere, no.
I don't have your face. It's for Jack.
What?
It's for Jack.
It's from you, mom, is it?
No, it's from me and Jack.
Don't lie, you like.
Okay, it's obviously a piss take, but I just want to tell you about it. It's Connect 4. What's Connect 4? Are we throwing in your head?
It's from me and Jack now.
Oh, what? You're such a play. I was talking them all week about it, like.
And we had got them, like, they were in my bedroom. They were in.
I copped straight away.
You delighted?
Yeah.
Say thanks to Jack.
Jack and
them. Me and Jack, if me
had.
Well,
I feel like
to...
it was Jack's idea.
No.
You're wrong.
Lexi, what's he get? What's he get?
That was
It's like a surprise. And they're the real deal, like.
I can tell, yeah.
I give a good spot. I got them.
Did you? They're very good. He has the fake pair.
Yeah.
Fuck
him.
He's given them to me.
I actually hate the whole door and the plug behind me. I really need to get a tapestry. But also I really don't need to spend any money, you know. I really do want to get a tapestry though. Just to hang. Cause like, and also that door freaks me out. So anyone wondering, that is the door into the attic. Yeah, you heard me right, the attic beside my bed. Some people may get creeped out by that. Doesn't really bother me. I'm just gonna cover it with a tapestry. I'm gonna order a tapestry from somewhere online, maybe Etsy actually. I have never really used Etsy before, but I feel like it would be a good place to buy a tapestry from, because I initially thought in my head Amazon, and then I was like, Becca, you need to stop giving Jeff Bezos money. He does not need any more, you know? So I'd rather just support maybe someone who is making them from home or something. Of course, I found one, 52 euro. Very cool though. It's a yin yang. I feel like a yin yang is very like apt for my personality. There's good and the bad, there's bad and the good. Even though I'm more of a good and the bad person. Oh, another one, 29. Oh, that's pretty. I think, okay, I'm stuck on a yin yang now. We're like some type of spiritual thing. Okay, anyway, so I'm gonna look for a tapestry. That wasn't what I came on to vlog about. It just happened, you know, things just happen. But I bought 2 new books on Audible there. Well, I actually didn't. I love how I literally just said, I'm not gonna support Jeff Bezos, and I'm talking about Audible, which is obviously on my Amazon. But I do love Audible. Like, I think it's a really good service, especially if you love books, because I do have Amazon Prime. Again, I'm actually just a walking hypocrite, but I have Amazon Prime because of the Audible. Like, if you have Amazon Prime, so what Amazon Prime is basically, I love how I'm literally selling it, you know, but you know, if there was another alternative to Audible, I would support, but right now there isn't. Anyway, if you have Amazon Prime, it means you get free shipping on anything you order on Amazon, and like priority shipping, and you get an Audible credit every month. So you get a book, essentially. You can get, like, with an Audible credit, you can get any book, doesn't matter. But all my credits were gone because I actually had already used, I had 2 credits and I used them this week. So I got Many Lives, Many Masters, a book that Dana, the astrologer, recommended to me on Monday, like, finished that in one go. And then I got a book that I had wanted to get for a while, Ask and It Is Given. Why don't I just show you? Hold on. Okay, this is better. So yes, this is my Audible library. So James Smith, Not a Diet Book. I had more in my library, but I don't know where they went. Carol Dweck, Mindset. I actually need to finish that one. Super Attractor. Again, you can see a theme. Many Life, Many Masters, finish that. Asking It Is Given, I just started listening to that yesterday. But then today, so obviously today is a full moon, and it also signifies the end of the first half of the year, and you kind of want to think about what you want to happen for the second half of the year. So clearly I just want to hustle. So I bought these 2 books. I'd actually been eyeing up this one from Patricia Bright for a while. I was actually thinking of doing her, she has a course as well, like a business kind of influencer-y course. So I wanted to do that, but I said I'd get the book first. And my top tip with Audible, if you are going to download it, is always make sure any book you get is narrated by the author. So like Patricia wrote the book, Patricia reads it, and 50 Cent wrote this book and 50 Cent reads that, because in my opinion, from listening to books on Audible, I connect with them more if they're read by the author. Like this one isn't, and it shows, but like the James Smith one was, and like sped through that, love that. So yeah, I would always recommend kind of getting titles that are narrated by the author. It just makes sense. But yeah, so those are the 2 books that I just bought. I'm very excited because we are making moves for the second half of the year, honeys. Okay, we are making moves. So that's what I'm currently doing. I also do have to work out because my check-in with Kiki is tomorrow. I haven't worked out today. I also need to film and edit a YouTube video, and it is now 3:40. So I don't know where the hours, I think the hours in the day are for all this, but yeah, I've a lot to do, and I'm procrastinating and buying books on Audible. Anyway, back to tapestry shopping. What is wrong with me? So yeah, as you saw, Ben got his presents. He was so shocked. We threw him so off the scent of getting AirPods for his birthday, and he was actually shocked. Like, he was actually, I think I'm going to bleep out his response because obviously it was explicit. That is our Ben. Anyway, okay, I'm gonna work out now because as you can tell, I'm kind of buzzing, full moon energy, and procrastinating my workout.
2, 1, 2, 3, go. Saturday, 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 Saturday. Hello, hi, good morning. I feel like it's a running theme this week where it's never actually the morning when I say good morning, because it is, lads, we're very bad. It's 3:20. Like, I didn't just get up. Like, I get up at around, I think it was like 10:30. Had a bit of a sleep in, you know, and I did my Kiki check-in first thing Saturday morning. You know how it goes. Heard back from Kiki and she was like, oh my god, you're doing so well on your plan. And I was kind of being really hard on myself, which isn't like me. And then My period's still here, still not gone. We love that for me. Even though I think today's the last day. If you're a girl, you'll know what that means. You'll know how you know it's kind of the last day. But yeah, so do you know what I'm gonna get later, lads, for dinner? McDonald's. And like, I'm not a big McDonald's fan. McDonald's wouldn't be a regular thing in my life. And I think that's because mainly the McDonald's in my hometown is far away. Like, you have to drive to get to it. Like, it's not in the center of the town. It's out in the outskirts of the town. So like, I wouldn't really be near it often. And obviously, like, I can drive, but I don't drive, you know? So yeah, like, when I lived in Australia, I lived like above a McDonald's, and I would have had it more regularly than I have it at home because it was quite close. But I wouldn't have had it, like, it would have been maybe once a month, if even, kind of thing. But it was closed for so long in Ireland because obviously Corona. So I said, I was kind of feeling it all week, McDonald's. So I said, I might get that for dinner. I think that's what I kind of feel like, you know, a good old McDonald's. But you know what I have to do now? I have to film a video because I just was not in the headspace all week to film a video. And I saw like everything going on, and like, you know, I feel like whether you're in, like, if you're informed and if you're aware of what's going on in the world, like, sometimes it can take a toll on you. And like, yes, I'm using my voice and I'm using my platform, and to be honest, I've never been shy about using it before. Like, maybe yes, I could have posted more raising awareness to issues, but as I said a few days ago, like, you could literally, like, I could have an activist IG account. Like, it could be at Rebecca Short Activist and just post every day what's going on in the world, what I think people need to bring their attention to. But also, like, it's not up to me to bring everyone's attention. Like, you can't, like, as what's her name, Kyla Cobbler, I only started following her on Instagram, like, she's great, but as she said, like, you can't bring a horse to water, do that kind of way. So basically what I'm saying is, I just wasn't in any mood to film any video. But last night was the new moon. I got 2 new books yesterday and I started reading them, and I kind of just did a lot of inner work on myself. And I was like, look, I think my main thing is, like, and I know people might like get cringed out when I say this, but like, I do, like, I can't deny I have a platform. Like, Instagram, nearly 5,000. YouTube, nearly 2,000. TikTok, 14,500. Facebook, 3,000. But like, do we even count Facebook anymore? Is that really relevant? Don't even post there, really. But basically what my point is technically that's 20,000 or over. And I know obviously a lot of them might cross over between platforms, but you know, not everyone who's on TikTok is on Instagram, YouTube's on Instagram, and it doesn't all cross over. So basically, like, do you know, when you have some level of influence, I feel like it's ignorant not to use it, do that kind of way. And I'm very aware of what I say and what I do and how it looks, because I always have good intentions and I never want to look ignorant or to look bad. But then you can't control how everyone views you. Like, if someone thinks you're a bad person, they've made up their mind, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to have a little chat, but first of all, I would say this is my morning monster, but it's actually not, because I've already had one, but I need to film a video, so I felt like I needed more energy. But now that I'm talking to you and I'm realizing that I'm talking really fast and like off on a tangent, I feel like I don't really need this, but I'm going to drink it anyway because it's ice cold and it's Saturday, so why not? Also, I have a lot of editing to do today, so I feel like I need the energy. Maybe I could wait until I've started editing to drink this, but here we go. There is a brand called Oma Beauty, I think it is, or Uoma Beauty. Because the other way, when you follow brands on Instagram, you don't know exactly how to pronounce it. Uoma Beauty, Oma Beauty. And it is a black-owned business, and the owner, Sharon, basically created an Instagram today and created a move, or not today, during the week, and created a movement called Pull Up or Shut Up. So she was basically calling on brands to kind of be transparent about who they employ, who works for them, and like how many, basically, like how diverse their team is. And I think this is very important. So basically she's called on a lot of brands to do this and a lot of brands have replied. So brands like Farrah Sally, Huda Beauty, Wet n Wild, Elf was one of the first, Milk Makeup, Revolution, Ulta Beauty, Glossier, Nude Sticks, you get it. So a lot of brands have replied. And I'm sure a lot of brands are in the process of like gathering their data depending on how big or small they are. And I've started a notes section in my phone. And it's literally called, here we go, brands that actually stand for something. So I feel like before, you know, you'd buy makeup that's on trend, you'd buy makeup that people recommend, you'd buy makeup that you see people on YouTube use, or like skincare products or hair care products, or, you know, depending where the recommendation came from. Maybe you never really thought what the brand stands for. You didn't really, like, you know, every brand has a mission statement, every brand stands for something. And I know most recently that like the brand that I was most aware of what they stood for was Tala, Grace Beverly's brand. And I only am aware of that because she only launched it recently. So when she launched it, she basically said on social media that they stand for diversity, inclusivity, like all her campaigns, that all different people of all shapes, sizes, colors, genders, like everything. So I, in my mind, knew that Tala was a very diverse brand and also very ethical and like everything basically you want a brand to be, really. And it being owned by a straight, white, blonde, very pretty female, it's amazing to see the diversity and everything like that. So I knew Tala was kind of diverse, but when it came to my own products, like even looking on my desk and looking on my shelf and looking around my room, and thinking about what I use, I was like, I'd like to know, because you know the way, especially with me, I feel, I spend my money on products. And not only do I do that, but I recommend them. So I give those brands essentially more sales. You know, I can see the data, I can see the link clicks, and I see like who, like when people click on links that I recommend, whatever. So I'm giving these brands money, I'm recommending them, I'm putting people onto brands and products they probably never knew about, and I myself might not know what that brand stands for. So basically, you might be like, Rebecca, it's not that deep, like I don't understand why it needs to be that deep, but I would be a very opinionated person, and I would be a very strong personality, I would think of myself. And also with the birth chart reading this week, I realized that a lot of my personality relies on using my voice and talking to people and using my positive energy and positive influence to help people and to better people and to, you know, keep people in a good headspace, or at least try to, and at least be that positive influence that people see. And that's basically like, might sound cringy, life mission. So, if I'm all of these things, how can I stand behind a brand or recommend a brand when I don't know what they stand for, how diverse they are, what their morals are? And like, you might be like, Rebecca, it's just a brand, like how are you supposed to know? But like, it's kind of important. Like, it's important to know. Like if I was setting up a brand tomorrow, I would want it to be very clear what my brand stands for and what we're all about, who we support, who we're here for, you know, that we're inclusive, that like, you know, so that people are aware. It would be very important to me if I started a brand, whatever it was, that people knew the brand's values, what it stood for, and then people could align themselves with the brand or not. So basically, this is me in a very massive roundabout way saying that I am going to make sure and ensure that whatever brands I align myself with in the future, not even working with, because obviously I don't work with any brands at the moment. No one has slid into the DMs and been like, Rebecca, we need you. We need you to tell the people, you know? I still have a choice to align myself with a brand and to recommend, and especially if those brands cost more money, if they are expensive. I want
to make sure basically that whatever I recommend has, you know, something attached to it, that it's not just as frivolous and as fickle as me recommending you a body moisturizer. Sorry, I was trying to think of a product there. Like, say, okay, we're gonna go in with examples because I'm a teacher. I'm not really a teacher, but you know. This is the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream that I've been recommending in my last few videos. So it's very relevant. It is also quite expensive, but also Sol de Janeiro is a brand owned by a Korean woman, and I think there was like three initially in the team, a Korean woman, a Brazilian woman, and another Brazilian man, I think. So it is a diverse brand. You go onto their website, it screams diversity. It's not just four white girls in bikinis on the site. They have an amazing brand message and mission statement. So, and this is me basically being like Sol de Janeiro, like hire me, send me stuff, like, but I'm not. I'm just saying it as an example because I've mentioned it so much on my YouTube channel recently that I feel like, you know, it's good for me to talk about these things because I care about this. So I'm assuming someone somewhere on my out there who subscribes to me cares. This is like the body revolution. This is on their thing. This literally looks like I'm being paid by Sol de Janeiro to say this right now, but I'm honestly not. I just kind of want to relate this to something so you understand what I'm trying to say. So basically it says, at Sol de Janeiro, we love life and love our bodies. We're here to celebrate everybody. No rules, only celebration. The best part, when you feel it, others feel it too. Kick off that body joy chain reaction. So basically, it's kind of funny as well because obviously my boyfriend's Brazilian, but lol. Living in Brazil for 10 years, I learned why people love the Brazilian mindset. It's so positive. It's about loving yourself and loving life. Mark, creative director and co-founder. Growing up in Brazil, I know the feeling of happiness that is so palpable. Nothing's more important than being close to those you love. We want soft, touchable skin and we always want to smell amazing. And love it, flaunt it, you've got it. It's basically like their slogan. So as you can see, this is a brand that really aligns with me, with my message of positivity. They're very inclusive, they're very open on what they support. Their Instagram has been very inclusive. It's never screamed non-inclusive to me, and on doing my research, it never screamed that. They were very vocal on their stories. Their Instagram, if you look at it, is made up of people, and not only this week, which is important, of all different shapes, sizes, colors, ethnicities, like everything, their whole Instagram. So basically what I'm saying is I'm not going to shut off about this brand, but this is just one example of a brand that I use that maybe, like, before this week, I loved it because I loved the smell. But then when I read more into it, I was like, okay, this actually really aligns with me, like their whole brand message. I basically watched a YouTube video of like the CEO and founder explaining like their whole brand message, their whole message behind their brand, and like body positivity and loving yourself and loving your life, and you know, that every body is beautiful kind of thing. And I was like, oh my God, that aligns so much with me. And like, then I thought about it and I was like, I get way more joy out of using this product knowing that it comes from a company that I align with than I would out of a body moisturizer that I wouldn't, if that makes sense. And I'm not trying to say like you have to research every brand before you buy it, but I think by being more conscious of these little things, we can all make changes in our lives for the better. And I'm gonna help you with that, because basically what I'm saying is, from now on, any brand I recommend or anything I recommend in my vlogs and on my across my channel will have, I will know what the brand stands for. I will confidently align myself with them, and I won't recommend you anything, and I won't be vocal about anything that I think comes from basically a money hungry corporation that, you know, doesn't care about anyone or anything and doesn't really have a strong message or
Not even that, like obviously a brand can have a strong message, they can write down, oh yeah, this is it, but doesn't act like they do, you know? So yeah, that's me and my little update for you all. I say you're all like, Rebecca, please shut up. Like, okay, we get it, you know? But I just think it was important for me to say that and important for me to align. Like, I take what I do seriously, and I take, like, if you know me or if you are subscribed to me, I'm sure you would have heard me mention things and be like, I'm not going to talk about this now till I use it, till I know whether or not to recommend it to you. I was always like that, whereas now I'm kind of taking it to the next level, which is kind of good, kind of fun, kind of fresh. There's times when I would love to drive, and this is one of those times. So my mom was over near the McDonald's, so I was like, look, on your way home, if there's not too big of a queue, will you pick it up for me? She's like, yeah, no problem. She rang me and she said the queue is monstrous, and like, obviously I don't expect her to sit in the queue and queue up for it, so I don't know how, like, I'd enjoy to try again later, but I don't know how I'm gonna work this. But I also just really want the McDonald's. I don't know what else. Like, it's not like I just want burger and chips. Like, it's a McDonald's, you know? I don't know what you would get to satisfy a McDonald's craving. Like, I don't want Thai food. I'm kind of hungry as well. It's 5:30 and I'm gonna edit this confidence video that I just filmed. So if you haven't seen that, I will leave it at the end of this video so you can click and watch that next. I think it's a really good one. I think the message behind it is really good, and I hope that someone somewhere gets something from it. Also, sorry, on my video that I posted last Sunday about, you know, being white, being privileged, all that kind of stuff, the Trump supporters have now found it somehow on the internet. So I obviously deleted them. Like, literally, when someone comes in with a comment that is just blatantly rude and like uncalled for, and it wasn't even a rude comment, it was just like Trump 2020, like, you should be like, all this kind of like stupid stuff about like how Trump is like God. Obviously we don't stand him on this channel, so what I did was I just hid the user from my channel so they can't see my channel anymore, so they can't comment whatever else they want to comment, and then reported the comment as spam, so hopefully YouTube will see it and stop them from commenting on other people's videos. So I'm finished editing my video. I haven't actually edited a video in the longest, well, what feels like the longest time, it's really not even a week, but to me that feels so long. Like, I haven't edited a video since last Saturday night, so literally a week. It was nice to kind of refresh the creative juices. Obviously the video I'm editing now isn't the most creative because I had a very deep, very honest self-love chat that hopefully will benefit a lot of you. It's also lashing rain outside, it's really cold, it's like winter has came out of nowhere. But will I show you the weather, since I'm such a big fan of feckin' doing it? It's actually not too bad. I explained it a lot worse than it actually is. But this is the vibe. Lovely grey sky, lovely rain falling from my roof. So yeah, we're gonna close that. So I don't know what to do. Also, fun fact, this used to be my selfie spot when I first started putting up like selfies on it, like makeup selfies on Instagram. I used to do my makeup and I used to stand here like in front of my shower and open my Vlux, because I have a Vlux, and like stand here and like pose and like do. Like, what a shitty background, like my thing. Or else I used to do this. I used to close in the door and I used to go here, which is like the white tiled wall background, and I used to try and like get a selfie here, like by the door. But like, this was like the best lighting that I could find in my room. Like, no denying, it's fantastic lighting, it's phenomenal. But like, the whole shower in the background. I remember another time I tried to hang up like a pink blanket. Lads, it was so funny. Like, I remember, like, and I'd be here for ages trying to get like the good angles and the good selfies. But now I'm about taking more like relaxed photos, and like, I don't really care. We need to get this McDonald's. It's actually happening. I don't care. I'm so hungry. And also, I still have my period, so I only want the McDonald's. Finally got in the queue for McDonald's. Lexi, you excited? Lexi, you excited? I got McDonald's. Yes, I did. I got a chicken nugget. I'm in the middle of eating my McDonald's. Chicken nuggets, chips. I don't think they have this all over the world, but in Ireland, sweet and sour dip and a double cheeseburger, because McDonald's, sweetie, it's been a while. It has been a while. So I'm going to enjoy this whilst watching a YouTube video.
I would say I'm so full after that McDonald's, but we all know McDonald's doesn't really make you full.
I literally only showed you the quickest lip because I was actually... Why is there all black under my eye? Because I hate when my food is cold. Like, I have to eat my food when it's hot, like when it's fresh. It is now, what time are we? 10:15 on a Saturday night. 10:15 on a Saturday night. And I still have to edit my weekly vlog. Yeah, so I'm gonna close off this week's vlog here. Thank you all so much for watching. Thankfully, it wasn't just a 24-hour trend, and it isn't just a 24-hour trend because it happened long before now, and hopefully, like, there was massive protests today all over Ireland. I live in County Kerry, so there's actually no protests where I live, unfortunately, but there was a massive one in Galway, a big one in Dublin, and there was massive ones in England as well today, and like, it's so uplifting for me to see all the protests. I know a lot of people are complaining about them because there's a global pandemic, but I'm kind of like, genuinely, it's more important. Like, it is more important. Like, you can't just say, oh, why don't they do that when the pandemic's over? Because you can't just pause a protest. Like, you can't pause people being upset, angry, and furious about everything that was happening with racism and with, you know, George Floyd and with Breonna Taylor. And like, her case was reopened because of public pressure, and that's why people protest. Like, I don't know if you knew, but like, anything that happened, whether it was with gay rights, whether it was with women's rights, like, women are allowed to work because of protests, you know. Women are allowed to like wear pants because of protests, you know. Things just don't happen. So to anyone saying like, oh, they should have just waited to have the protests, or oh, I don't really agree with them, it's like, how do you expect the world to change? Like, it's not just gonna change. And like, also the people at protests, you know, they're maintaining as much social distancing as they can. I'm sure they're all being hyper aware, washing their hands and everything. You know, it is what it is. And if you don't want change, or if you're privileged enough to think it wasn't necessary, I'm sure that if people were protesting against the color of your skin, or if people were protesting to fight for the color of your skin, you wouldn't have a problem with it. So just kind of peel it back, folks. Let's just peel it back. Let's not get too up in ourselves, and remember the reason why they're happening and why they're so important. So I'm gonna leave you on that note. Again, just a quick reminder, any and all revenue I make from ads and YouTube will be going to multiple charities in line with the Black Lives Matter movement and also ending direct provision in Ireland. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will see you in the next video on Wednesday, or the next weekly vlog next Sunday. You're all amazing. You're all sound. You're all legends. I hope you're all okay. I hope all your, you know, family is okay, all your friends are okay, and that everything is okay where you are. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.